okay, take down the problem. It is called milling machine problem or bearing machine problem. A large milling machine has three different bearings. Okay, a large milling machine has three different bearings that fails in service. Okay, the distribution of life of each bearing is identical and is as shown in the table. That is, bearing lives are given, that is 1000, 1100, 1200, 1300, 1400, 1500, 1600, 1700, 1800, and 1900. These are the bearing in life. And its probability is also given. That is 0.10, 0.13, 0.25, 0.13, 0.09, 0.12, 0.02, 0.06, 0.05, 0.05. Okay. When the bearing fails, the mill stops. Okay. When the bearing fails, the mill stops. The repair person is called and a new bearing is installed in. Okay. The delay time of the repair person arriving at the milling machine is also a random variable with the distribution is given below. Okay. The delay and probability for the repair person arrival also is given here. Delay is 5, 10, 15 and probability is 0.6, 0.3, 0.1. Okay, next we understand the problem here carefully. The downtime for the mill is estimated at $5 per minute. Okay, downtime for the mill is estimated $5 per minute. The direct on-site cost of the repair person is $30 per hour. The direct on-site cost of the repair person is $30 per hour. Okay. It takes 20 minutes to change one bearing. It takes 20 minutes to change one bearing and 30 minutes to change two bearings. 40 minutes to change three bearings. Okay. The bearing cost is $32. A person has been made to replace all three bearings whenever a bearing fails. If any one bearing fails also, we need to replace all three bearings. How much time it will take if you want to change all three bearings? It will take 40 minutes. Okay. And management needs to evaluation of the proposal, simulate the system for 10,000 hours of operation. If 10,000 hours of operation, management wants to evaluate the simulate the system, okay, under 10,000 hours of operation under the proposed method and determine the total cost. Consider the following random digit for the bearing life. Okay, here they have given the random digit for the bearing life. Bearing 1, these are the random digits, that is 67, 8, 49, 84, 44, 30, 10, 63. Bearing 2, it is given as 70, 43, 86, 93, 81, 44, 19, 51. Bearing 3, it is given 76, 65, 61, 96, 65, 56, 11, 86. Consider the following sequence of random digit for delay. Delay's random digit also is given here. That is 3, 5, 7, 1, 4, 3, 7, 8. This is the random digit for the delay. Okay. Now we need to construct the simulation table. First we'll do, in the question they have given, bearing life hours they have given and its probability it is given. Okay. So we'll construct a bearings lives distribution table will construct. Bearing life is given in that question as, you can see here in the problem, bearing lives given and its probabilities are given. This is the bearing life and probability. Copy this as it is in the solution. Bearing life, that is bearing life hours are 1000. 1100, 1200, 1300, 1400, 1500, 1600, 1700, 1800, and 1900. Okay, and its probabilities 0.10, 0.13, 0.25, 0.13, 0.09, 0.12, 0.02, 0.06, 0.05, 0.05. This is the probability. Now we know the probability, we know how to calculate the cumulative probability. The first one's cumulative probability is always the probability itself. Okay, this is the probability. Probability of first one is 0.10, so that will be the cumulative probability for the first one. For second one, cumulative probability to calculate, we need to add the previous one cumulative probability and present one's probability. That is 0.10 plus 0.13, we will get 0.23. And 0.23 plus 0.25, we will get 0.48. 0.48 plus 0.13, we will get 0.61. 0.61 plus 0.09, we will get 0.70. 0.70 plus 0.12, we will get 0.82. 0.82 plus 0.02, we will get 0.84. 0.84 plus 0.06, we will get 0.90. 0.90 plus 0.05, we will get 0.95. 0.95 plus 0.05, we will get 1.0. This is the way we calculate the cumulative probability. After calculating the cumulative probability, we need to assign the random digit. To assign the random digit, first we need to decide whether it is a 2-digit random digit or 3-digit random digit. You can see here for the bearings in the question, they have given random digits in 2 digits. So we need to assign 2-digit random digit only. Okay. So the random digit always starts from the 1. 1 to its cumulative probability is 0.10. So it is 1 to 10. The first one's random digit assignment is 1 to 10. Next one random digit assignment will start from 11, because the first one random digit is assignment is ended with 10. So next one random digit assignment will start from 11. 11 to its cumulative probability is 0.23. So 11 to 23. Next one random digit assignment is will start from 24. 24 to its cumulative probability is 48. 24 to 48. Next one is it will start from 49. And its cumulative probability is 0.61. So 49 to 61. Next one random digit will start from 62. 62 to its cumulative probability 70. It is 62 to 70. Next one random digit will start from 71. And its cumulative probability is 82. So 71 to 82. Next one's random digit assignment will start from 83. Its cumulative probability is 84. So 83 to 84. Next one's random digit assignment will start from 85. Its cumulative probability is 90. So 85 to 90. Okay. Next one's cumulative probability will start from 91. And its cumulative probability is 95. Okay. So the random digit assignment will start from 91 to 95. Okay. Next one's random digit assignment will start from 96. Here the cumulative probability is 1.0. So we can't take, we should not write 96 to 100. If you write it 100, it will become 3-digit random digit. So the range of random digit assignment here will be 96 to 99, and 00 will be the range of random digit assignment here. Okay. This is the bearing life distribution random digit assignment table. Next, in the question, they have given the delay time and its probability. Now we need to calculate cumulative probability, because we have the delay time and probabilities are given in the question. You can see here. Delay time and probability, we'll copy as it is from the question. And we'll calculate the cumulative probability and we'll assign the random digit for this. So always the first one's cumulative probability will be same as the probability. Second one cumulative probability will be calculated from the first one cumulative probability, we'll add with the present one's probability. That is 0.6 add with 0.3, we will get 0.9. 0.6 plus 0.3, it is 0.9. Next one, 0.9 plus 0.1, we will get 1.0. Okay, like this, we need to calculate the cumulative probability. After calculating the cumulative probability, we need to assign the random digit. Okay, always the random, before assigning the random digit, first we need to decide whether it is single digit random digit or two digit random digit or three digit random digit. Here they have given random digit for the delay in the question is single digits. Okay, so we need to assign single digit random digit. So here always random digit will start from 1. 1 to, it is, its cumulative probability is 0.6. So it is random digit is we assign as 1 to 6. Okay. Second, next one's random digit will start from 7 as the previous one's random digit is ended with 6. Okay. We'll start the random digit from the 7. 7 to 9 because its cumulative probability is 0.9. So the random digit we assign from 7 to 9. Next one random digit is, because we can't assign the random digit 10 here. If you assign the 10, the random digit will be two digit random digit it will become. So, and its cumulative probability is 1.0. So we should take only zero as, we should assign the random digit as zero for this. Okay. This is the delay time distribution table. Next, we need to construct the simulation table. Okay. Simulation table consists of, here they have given in the question 8 sets of bearings. Okay, 8 sets we need to run the simulation here. And bearing times, bearings random digit also is given in the table. We'll given in the question, bearing one's random digit. So this is the bearing one's random digit, bearing two random digit, bearing three random digit. We'll copy to the solution. Bearing one's random digits are given in the question is 67, 8, 49, 84, 44, 30, 10, 63. Now we need to find where the 67 comes in this random digit assignment. 67 comes here in the range of 62 to 70. If it is 62 to 70, what is the bearing lifetime? That is 1400. So we'll write 1400 here. Okay. And for 8, what is the lifetime? 8 is random digit comes in the range of 1 to 10. Its lifetime is, bearings lifetime is 1000. We'll write 1000 there. Okay. Next, 49, where it comes in the range, 49 comes in the range of 49 to 61. 49 to 61, the bearing life is 1300. So we'll write 1300 there. Okay, then 84, where it comes in the range, 84 comes in the range of 83 to 84. Okay, 83 to 84, what is the bearing lifetime? That is 1600. We'll write 1600 here in the table. Okay, we'll write 1600. Next, 44, where it comes in the range, 44 comes in the range of 24 to 48. Okay. 24 to 48, it is 1200. So we'll write 1200 here. Okay. 1200 we'll write here. Next, 30. Where the 30 comes in the range? 30 comes in the range of 24 to 48. 24 to 48, what is the bearing lifetime? Bearing lifetime is 1200. So we'll write 1200 here. Okay. And Next it is 10. 10 is the random digit. For 10 random digit, where it comes? It comes in the range of 1 to 10. Okay, 1 to 10, what is the bearing life? It is 1000. So we'll write 1000 here. Okay, we'll write 1000 here. Next random digit is 63. 63 random digit, where it comes in the range? 63 comes in the range of 62 to 70. Its bearing life is 1400. We'll write 1400 here. Okay, like this, by using the random digit, we have calculated the bearing life for the bearing set, bearing one. Okay, now in the question it is given random digit for the bearing two. Bearing two random digit is given in the problem is 70, 43, 86. Okay, you can see here in the question it is given. Bearing two's random digits. Bearing two random digits is 70, 43, 86, 93, 81, 44, 19, 51. So we'll write as it is that. Okay, we will write the random digit and we will find again this random digit where it comes in the bearing life distribution table. 70, where it comes in the table, 70 comes in the range of 62 to 70. 62 to 70, what is the bearing life? It is 1400. So we'll write 1400 here. Okay, like that we need to write it for all the random digit lifetime. We need to write it for bearing 2. And bearing 3 is random digit also given in the question. That is, you can see here, bearing 3 is random digits also given. Bearing 3's random digits are this thing. 76, 65, 61, 96, 65, 56, 11, 86. We'll copy to the simulation table. Okay. This is 76, 65, 61, 96, 65, 56, 11, 86. 76, where it will come in the distribution table? 76 comes in the range of 71 to 82. 71 to 82, what is the bearing lifetime? That is 1500. So we'll write 1500 here. Okay, then 65, where it comes in the range? It comes in the 65 comes in the range of 62 to 70. Its bearing lifetime is 1400. We'll write 1400 here. Okay, like this, same way we should write it for all the random digit. Okay, after writing this, we need to find first failure. Okay, here we have in one set we have three bearings, right? In three bearings, which will get fail first? Okay, which is having the less lifetime, less bearing lifetime will get fail first. So here the bearing one is having the lifetime 1400, bearing two is having lifetime 1400, bearing three is having the lifetime 1500. The first failure will be the bearing which is having the 1400 as its life. Okay, among these three, which is having the less lifetime, that we need to write here. Okay, here we have second one. Second set we have 1000, 1200, 1400. Which one will get fail first? 1000 lifetime. So 1000 will write it here. Next set we have 1300, 1700, 1300. In this, which bearing will get fail first? That is, which is having the lifetime is least lifetime. That is 1300. So we'll write 1300 here. Next set four, we have 60 bearing lifetime is 1600, 1800, 1900. In this, among these, which is having the least lifetime? That is 1600. So 1600 will get fail first. Next we have 1200, 1500, 1400. Among this, which is having the least lifetime? That is 1200. So we'll write 1200 here. Next 1200, 1200, 1300. Among this, which is having the which will fail first? That is 1200 is the least one among this 12 and 13. Among this, 12 is the least one. So we'll write 1200 is will get failed. Okay. Next, we have lifetimes are 1000, 1100, 1100. Among these, which is having the least lifetime, that is 1000. So bearing one will get failed. So 1000 is the first failure lifetime of the bearing. Okay. Next, 1400, 1300, 1700. Among these, the least one is 1300. So 1300 is the first failure. Okay. At 1300, first failure will occur. Okay. If you add all these things, we'll get 10,000. Okay. 10,000 hours will be, the system will work for 10,000 hours because we have calculated all the first failures. Okay. If we'll add the 1400 plus 1000 plus 1300 plus 1600 plus 1200 plus 1200 plus 1000 plus 1300, we'll get 10,000. And in the question, they have given for random digit for delay. That is 357. You can see here in the problem. Random digit for delay. That is 357 14 378. So we'll write that as it is. And we need to find the delays for these random digit. Okay, random digit 357 14 378 is given in the question. For random digit 3, what is the delay we need to find? Where the 3 will come in the random digit 1 to 6 range, 3 will come. And what is the delay? It is 5. For 3, it is 5 is the delay. For 5, where it comes in the range? 5 comes in the range of 1 to 6. What is the delay? It is again 5. Okay, we'll write 5 here. For 7, 7 comes in the range of 7 to 9. Its delay is 10. We'll write 10 here. Okay, we'll write 10 here. Okay, next 1. 1 come, 1 where comes in this range? 1 comes in the range of 1 to 6. What is the delay? Delay is 5. So we'll write delay here as 5. Okay, like this we need to write for all the random digits. Okay, if you write all the random delays, if you calculate the total delay will be 5 plus 5 plus 10 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 10 plus 10. Okay, total delay will be 55 minutes is the total delay. Okay, and total hours, bearing hours is bearing 1's total hours plus bearing 2's total hours plus bearing 3's total hours. So that is 32,900 hours is the total bearing hours. Okay. First failure hours is for the bearing is 10,000 hours. After 10,000 hours, bearings will get failed. Okay. Now we need to calculate. In the question, they have asked a few questions to calculate. That will do. The total cost of proposed system is estimated by using this. Okay. We need to find total cost for proposed system. So first we need to calculate the cost for the bearings. Okay. How to calculate the cost for the bearings? Here in the question they have given bearings is 8 sets of bearings. Okay. And each set we have how many bearings? We have 3 bearings will be there in each set. So 8 into 3. And what is the cost of each bearing? Each bearing cost is $32. So 8 into 3 into 32, we will get $768. Okay. 8, 3, 24 into 32, we'll get 768. So it is $768 is the cost for the bearings. Next, cost of the delay time. Okay, total delay time, how much we got? Delay time was, we have got, total delay time is 55 minutes. So 55 minutes, what is the cost for the delay in the question they have given? Cost for the delay they have given in the question is $5. Okay, if the system is down, the $5 will be the delay cost. Okay, if the person comes late, $5 will be costed for that. Okay, downtime for the mill is estimated as $5 per minute. So 55 into 5 will get the delay time. Okay, 55 into $5. Okay, cost for the delay time is 55 into $5, $5 per minute, that is $275 is the cost of the delay. Next, cost of the downtime. Cost of the downtime is total number of sets into how much time for one set to get repaired and what is the downtime cost. Okay, that is total is called as cost of the downtime. Okay, here we have 8 sets of bearings and 40 minutes it will take to replace the one set of bearing. If any one set fails also, we need to replace. If any one bearing fails also, we need to replace all 3 bearings. Okay, so 8 set into 40 minutes per set into downtime cost is $5. So 8 into 40 into $5, that is we will get $1,600. Okay, next, cost of the repair. Cost of the repair will be calculated like this. 8 sets into 40 minutes per set into, and how much cost for the 1 hour? Okay, that is $30 per hour. Okay, it will cost, repair cost will be $30 per hour. Okay, so 8 into 40 into 30, if you convert it into minutes, that is 8 into 40 into 30 divided by 60. We will get 160 minutes. Okay, and total cost is sum of all these things. Sum of cost of the bearings plus cost of the delay time plus cost of the downtime plus cost of the repair. That is the total cost. That is 768 plus 275 plus 1600 plus 160. We will get 2803 dollars is the total cost for the repairing. Okay, and the cost of 10,000 bearing hours. 10,000 bearing hours. What is the cost? We need to calculate. Okay, here the total cost for bearing we have got as $2,803. Okay, they have asked here to calculate it for 10,000 bearing hours. Here the total life of the bearing we have got 10,000, right? This is the average time is 10,000 is the total life of the bearing. Okay, and it is each bearing. Okay, that into 3. We have one set, we will be having 3 bearings. So 10,000 into 3, it is 30,000 hours is the total life of the bearing. So it is 2,803 divided by 3, we will get $934.33. Okay, this is the bearing machine problem.